Hello, everybody. It's me, Shyla Curbelo.
I'm Olivia Esquivel.
And welcome to Manic Monday, except it's not Monday. It's Wednesday. Yeah. Again. I'm sorry I didn't tell you guys that we started at 1 yesterday. I'm pretty sure you guys miss us. Sorry, mm-hmm. Jake. But today we were actually recording a segment for our Friday show, so make sure to check that out on Friday. We were doing a Guess Who challenge, and it was actually really fun.
It did go really well.
Yeah, we got kids from different classes here at the Media Center, and we basically had to guess whether or not they were a Fortnite player or not, and I got it from the beginning, just so everyone knows, I got it from the beginning, and you will see in the video, because we did a challenge, or we did a round where it was like, guess based off looks, who we think it is, and I got it from the start.
Got it second guess, all right? I got it second guess. My first guess was, you know, we won't even spoil it, but... I got it second try.
Yeah, that's a good idea, not to spoil it. Yeah. We also made them do Fortnite dances, so you guys have to go and check that out if you want to see some epic dance moves. We have Asher editing it right now, so yeah, make sure to go check that out on Friday. Honestly, if I was playing that
better
game...
Be
no, literally, we had to see if he was editing, because sometimes he watches movies, which is a no-no, but it's okay, he's editing, guys.
Just outing him right now.
Sorry. But honestly, if I was playing the game we were just doing, mm-hmm. I feel like people would vote me out as not
player. People would vote me out.
Yeah.
That's for sure.
Because I, like, when Asher asked, oh, okay. We're getting Asher, I guess. But.
We've outed Asher and now he's facing
Asher.
The consequences.
I'm so sorry. Wait, what was I saying? Yeah.
Oh, you would get guessed, or...
Yeah, guessed out, because yeah. Asher asked a question to one of the contestants saying, like, which spot do they land at? And honestly, I don't even know. I genuinely do not know any of the
I
spots.
Never go to Tilted Towers.
I
Because I'm not good, so I don't want to, like, get killed.
Well, yeah, I used to when I was, like, playing with people mm-hmm. by myself. I was too scared. That was not happening.
But if I'm going with someone else and someone's, like, carrying me, I will go to Tilted Towers, but, like... Never by myself.
Yeah, but do you know any of the other spots besides Tilted? Lazy Lake, right? Is that one?
There's like a tomato one.
Yeah, Tomato Town.
Yeah,
I think.
Tomato Town.
Guys, we could be completely wrong. Please don't quote us.
No, I know Tomato Town is real because it's in the song.
Oh yeah!
It's
oh
in the
my
Fortnite
god! Yeah,
song.
The song. Right. Okay. Then
maybe I would. Pass the
really?
Test.
Yeah. Okay, yeah, that makes sense. But I don't know any of the weapons, though. Like, I don't... Mm. Yeah, I don't know any of the things you
I
can
always
carry.
Purposefully pick up a revolver.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't know. I just kind of pick up stuff. I'm not even gonna lie. I don't even look at the names. And people always get on me for that. They're always like, oh, you should know, like, what you're, like, carrying, like, your loadout is and everything. I'm like... I
guess
I
you
don't.
Should
yeah,
know.
Genuinely, like, I don't care.
I guess you should know, but I never, like...
I just don't get what the
read
purpose
into it.
Is. Yeah, like I
or
don't
anything.
I don't see why the name of my choice is going to be like.
I guess like does damage
me.
Matter?
Yeah.
If you're worrying about damage, then like probably.
Yeah, like I can see based off the color of it. I can know which
yeah,
one
is
I
it
want.
Purple?
Yeah, is it? Oh, is that that purple? And I always think yeah. I'm
That's the one I want.
Yeah, I don't care about the name. But yeah, I would definitely get kicked out. Also, oh my god, when we were doing the dancing, because me and Olivia were just talking about how like which is our like favorite Fortnite dance. I love the True Heart dance, but I cannot do it for the life of me. I would like attempt to do it, and someone would like kick me out because they would be like, "Oh yeah, you don't know this." I probably saw it on TikTok or whatever.
My favorite is the Cupid one.
Yeah, I think. Yeah, I love how both of ours is like true. It's like part of the Valentine's Day item shop. I think it was.
Yeah,
yeah.
They both involve like hearts.
Yeah.
Anyway, that's good. to move on. For our song, dang, Valentine's Day was a long time ago.
Yeah.
Maybe it is slightly irrelevant, but I don't care. I love it anyway. Anyway. Next up, we have for you guys, I Love You So by The Walters.
Hi guys, we are back. That was I Love You So by the Walters. So since we were on Game Talk, you know, we want to talk about The Sims, which is me and Olivia's favorite game. I would say favorite shared game, right?
Yeah.
Yeah, I really do like The Sims. I was playing it like all this week, I'm not even going to lie. That was really fun. It's just because I saw like TikToks of Sims 2. Yeah. I don't know if you remember anything from Sims 2.
That's an old one.
Yeah, I remember, okay, the TikTok that I saw, it was this girl talking about how, like, easy it is for CPS to come and take your kids in Sims 2.
You could literally, like, be, like, 3 minutes late on not feeding them, and they're hungry, and, like, they will get taken away. But
yeah, in the video, she said that she was walking her cat. Like, she has a gameplay on there, and she's walking her cat, and she's not even down the block yet, and the truck pulls up to take her kids. It was so
I don't
terrible.
Think they do that in The Sims 4.
No, they don't. I don't think so. People
but doesn't the Grim Reaper take them?
Yeah, I think so. Oh, well, no, I think it could be both ways, actually. I'm pretty sure. Because I know
like,
people...
what happens if they don't die, but they still get taken away?
I think they just... the CPS comes and gets them.
That's never happened to me.
Oh, yeah. They said that it's actually way harder for it to happen in Sims 4. I remember when I first, like, experienced having, like, a kid in Sims, they were like, make sure to take care of your kid or else it would disappear. And I was like, huh?
Yeah, it's like, it does give you a little message that it says something like, or they'll get taken away, ..
Yeah, like really it was, like, really, like, huh?
Yeah.
I was kind of confused until I saw that TikTok video, and I didn't know about that in the game, so I was like, informed, but I feel like, oh my gosh, don't get me started on the freaking kitchen fires that Sims always have.
Never cook at 3 a.m. Don't even bother using the stove at 3 a.m. because your whole house will catch on fire and your Sim will die.
Honestly.
Like, every time.
No, just get rid of your stove completely.
No, literally.
Just
and don't even bother having a fireplace. Because the Sim will want it on 24/7 and it will burn their house
down. Wait, there's fireplaces?
Yeah.
I did not know that.
Yeah, maybe that's good because they're never good.
Oh, my God. Wait, so has your house burned down because of a fireplace?
Yeah.
Oh, my God.
It has. Because they always turn it on. And I don't know if that's, like, the game glitching. But, like, even if I turn the fireplace off, like, I make them, like, extinguish it, they will go back, like, 3 seconds later to turn it right back on.
That's stupid. I hate that so much. Like, when I'm, like, commanding my Sims to do something, and they just do completely the opposite thing. It's so annoying.
Especially when it's, like, because of that like, child message thing, I'll, like, send them, like, a command in the queue to, like, feed them.
Yeah.
And they'll, like, glitch, and they'll just be, like, walking around outside.
Yes,
and it's,
I
like, bro, like,
that.
Hurry. Like, I don't, they're gonna die. Like, please.
If you don't feed them in 3 seconds.
Literally.
But, yeah, I actually do remember that. They would, like, I would ask them to, like, go change its diaper, and it just would not do that. And I'm just like, oh, my gosh.
That's another one.
Yeah. I think, well, another thing that gets on my nerves is when, like, random Sims just come in your house, like, unannounced. Like,
you have to lock your door.
I just now figured that out, actually. But, like, when I used to play, they would always just come in my house, and I'm like, dude, like, I don't want these people in here. And I would, like, ask my Sims to, like, kick them out and stuff, so.
Which then, like, gives you, like, a red bar.
Yeah, that's what I was
saying. And all of a sudden, they're your enemy. And you're like, I'm not out here trying to make enemies. You're in my house, uninvited. Like, what?
Okay. No, literally.
That game is chaos.
Yeah, you want to talk about, like, the craziest thing that's happened to your Sims?
Oh, gosh. I haven't played The Sims in a hot second because I, like, get into, like, it's the same thing with Minecraft. Like, you play it, and then you play it for, like, a month, and then you don't play it for, like, years.
Yeah.
And then you play it straight for, like, a month. The craziest thing.
I know my sister was saying how, like, hers drowned.
Like,
they just...
I've also had a Sim drown.
It's, like, so easy for them to drown. Like, they just, they don't know how to swim for whatever reason.
But right.
That's why I'm never putting a pool in my house, by the way.
I always put a pool.
Really?
Yep, all the time.
No, I can't. Absolutely not.
But it's, like, I don't know, though. It's kind of like a... I don't know. You never know. Like, you could have a pool without a ladder.
Yeah.
And they will just, like, carry themselves up. But then some of them just stay there and drown.
Yeah,
like, some of them just don't know what to do.
They're dumb. They're
no,
dumb.
Literally.
We need a Sims 5 where they, like, they're just smart. They're geniuses. They know what they're doing.
Exactly.
Oh, also another thing that I hate is when they get, like, mad so easily about, like...
They do get so mad.
Like, something about, like, their dreams not coming true. And it's just, like, it was just, like, a whole thing. And it's just, like,
what?
Oh, my God.
Why is that? It's like it's orange, right?
Yeah.
It's because they're like tense.
Yeah, yeah. And I would be like, and it's just like the message is like, disturbed by unfulfilled dreams, and it's just like, dude,
bro,
I'm
like you have
3 days into the game, like no, let's calm down.
We're 3 days into the game, but you have a job, you have a husband, you have kids, you have
a nice
house.
Bed. Yeah, like
what do you mean your dreams are unfulfilled and you're on day three of life? Like. It just doesn't make any type of sense.
They want it all, I guess. But, you know, speaking of dreams, we're going to go to our great song, mm-hmm. which is Don't Dream It's Over by Crowded House.
That one's fire.
Hello, guys. We are back. That was Don't Dream It's Over by, I forgot the name.
Crowded House.
Yes, that is one of my favorite songs. It's in
The Perks of Being a Wallflower.
Yeah, I keep on saying To Be a Wallflower. I love that movie. You guys should watch it. It's really good. But we got a question while we were listening to that song, which is...
Why are Sims still dumb, like, now in the future with AI?
And we were, like, trying to think about that question. And honestly, we came up with the fact that, like, the game developers, they just want it to keep it, like, interesting. Like,
they just do it for the chaos.
Yeah, because, like, Sims is basically, like, that's what it's known for. Like, yeah. Anytime someone's, like, complaining about The Sims, it's always because it's chaotic.
But it's just to stress you out.
Yeah, which is, honestly, it makes it entertaining, which is fine. And which we actually did get the answer from one of our studio members, so thank you, Jake. They were saying that the game developers make it to where you would do a command, and then the game will just add a command, like, randomly. Like, say you're going to go put your baby to sleep. The game's going to put it in, jump in the pool. Because, you know, that makes sense, right? Yeah.
It's just to stress you out. Yeah. But, yeah, if you guys have any more questions, go ahead and...
Please ask us, because, you know, we're thinking about these. This one was really deep, honestly. That had me thinking for a little bit.
Because I have way too much, like, unneeded knowledge about The Sims, honestly. Like, I know cheat codes, even. Like, really? I literally know everything about The Sims.
Oh, yeah, she did tell you... Yeah. When you told me... Because this whole entire time, I've been, like, building my houses from, like, the ugly houses that they give you in the beginning. Yeah. I've just been, like, building it up. And then you told me about...
You can literally just get more money.
Yeah.
And you literally hit Shift-Control-C, and then you type motherload.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
Wait.
And it gives you 50,000 every time. So I literally do it, like, I'm just, like, sitting there, like, typing.
Are you joking?
No, I give myself a million, and then it gives me a reward in the corner. It's like, your Sim is a millionaire. And I'm like, yep, I worked really hard for that.
Okay, wait, Shift-Control-C?
Yeah, Shift-Control-C, motherload.
Okay, I'm going to need this clip so I can go back and check.
Shift-Control-C, and then it gives you a little white bar to type in cheat codes. So there's probably more cheat codes.
Okay.
That's how you, like, type in stuff.
Where did you get this information?
I've known this info since, like, 2016.
Oh, my gosh. I've known it forever. A Sims expert, because I did not know that. I've been, like, oh, my God. I've been playing Sims so normally, and now I'm upset. I could have a nice house.
Yeah.
I'm going to play Sims 2 day just to try this.
You guys have any more Sims questions, feel free to ask. I will inform the world. I will enlighten y'all about The Sims. But
watch The Sims creators be like, oh, they know too much.
They know too much. let's got to take Sims out down. Of here.
That would go crazy.
Literally.
But
what else were we going to talk about? Oh, prom.
Oh, yes. Okay, guys. So
speaking of the Perks of Being a Wallflower, they danced to...
Was that prom?
Or was that winter formal?
I think it was winter formal.
Okay, never
mind. Either way, it is a dance. So yeah. we also had a winter formal. I didn't go, though.
I didn't go either.
Yeah, but we are going to prom, and that is one thing. I actually got my prom shoes and jewelry yesterday.
You're going to have to show me.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Oh, and a bag. The bag actually matches the shoes. I think that's isn't that, like, a song? I don't know. Anyways, but, yeah. Maybe. And they were, like, actually really cheap. I got them at Shoe Carnival. They didn't really have that much of, like, a selection, though.
Mm-hmm.
But it was only, like, $35, I think. Oh, wait.
Did you guys put my cheat code at the bottom of the
screen? Oh, my God. Oh, my God. Yeah,
you guys are welcome. You're welcome.
Yeah, so if you guys play The Sims, go ahead and do that right now.
You guys
tell us
are
if
watching
it works.
On YouTube.
Please go check that out. But, yeah, I got them at Shoe Carnival, and it was only $35. And I got my homecoming shoes from there when it was homecoming. It was $70. So my prom heels are cheaper than my homecoming heels. But they look better.
Shoe Carnival got what's the word?
Like, bought out?
Like, when stores get shut down? There's a word for that. Bankruptcy, maybe? I don't know. I thought Shoe Carnival wasn't a thing
anymore. Oh, I think you're talking about somewhere. I know what you're talking about. I forgot the name of it. But, yeah, I know what you're talking about. But, yeah, it did get shut down.
Oh, maybe that was Payless.
Yeah, yeah. It was Payless. Isn't it, like, online now? Like, you can buy...
I don't know.
I'm pretty sure you can buy stuff online. Because I think it's, like, the same case with Toys R Us. Like, you can buy stuff off Toys R Us on their website. Yeah.
That was so sad.
Wait, what?
Toys R Us is coming back. Guys, the giraffe is coming back.
Wait, guys, we have news. Toys R Us is coming back. What? Oh, I didn't know that.
I may be, like, almost 18, but I'm really excited
about
Toys R Us.
Yeah, we should do
back.
A segment where we go to Toys R Us, relive our kid moments.
Literally. I will do that.
Yeah. But, anyways, my heels are, like, 1 inch tall, though. And that's what I didn't want. I wanted to see if they were,
like... Wait, so they're short?
Yeah, but it's okay, because now, on Friday, I'm going to have to do my dress, actually. I'm getting it tailored, and I have to make, like, the, what's like, the
like
part?
Hemet?
Yeah, but, like, what's the part that, like, drags? Is it cape?
What
am I thinking of?
The tail?
I think it's tail.
Train.
Yes, I'm going to have to shorten the train down because it's, like, really long, and the one-inch heels are just not going to do it for me. But you also went prom shopping yesterday.
Yeah, I went prom dress shopping yesterday, and I got shoes there. I don't know if I love them yet. Mm-hmm. I might look at other options, but I really love the dress.
Yeah, I saw it. It's really pretty.
I went from pink to dark blue. Yeah. So. We've got some news.
A press release at the beginning of 2024 announced that Toys R Us plans to open 24 stores nationwide in 2024. It also plans to open additional stores in airports and on cruise ships.
So what was the point of closing Toys R Us and making it a whole thing and having the giraffe freaking pack his bags and leave just for them to open up Toys R Us's and cruise ships?
Because they had to sell off.
I did not know all of that. Wow. That's actually funny. Wait, but they didn't even close that long ago, right? Like, I feel like it wasn't even that long.
6 years ago.
Six years ago?
2017.
Yeah.
Yeah. So, yeah.
I feel like I remember it being 2017 or something.
Yeah, so it wasn't that long ago, but I'm glad they're back. The new generation will know about Toys R Us.
They'll be able to experience my happiness.
Oh, really?
Oh, okay.
2017, 2018.
Oh, I did not know that. I don't remember the last time I was in a Macy's, though, to be fair.
Isn't Macy's also closed down?
No.
Or
nope.
It's getting closed down? That's Carson's.
What's Carson's?
Carson's is like, it was basically Kohl's and Macy's.
Oh.
Carson Peary Scott is what it's called.
It's like the, I miss Carson's. I would go there like all the time with my grandma.
Okay, yeah, I'm gonna. I was at the mall yesterday. I was at South Lake. Oh,
yeah.
Oh, there's a lot of places that were like that are closed down. Wait, what?
Back in.
Oh no.
Yeah. Yeah.
I just don't remember that. And my mom used to work at the mall too. She used to work at the Limited, and it closed down. So, like,
dang.
Yeah, a lot of people like lost their jobs at the mall.
Wait, what's the Limited?
It's like it was like a clothes brand. It was for like office jobs. Like, if you're like working an office job for women, and they had like really nice clothes. I actually still have Limited clothes from when she used to work there. But it like shut down like when I was in fifth grade, I want to say. I was pretty young, but yeah, she still has clothes from there, and she gave it to me. Because, you know, we have jobs now. We have to do interviews because we're turning 18. Guys, we're growing up.
It's getting really sad over here.
Yeah, but.
She's crying.
And you know what? I'm not rocking with growing up, so we're going to play Rock With You by Michael Jackson.
And we're back. That was Rock With You by Michael Jackson. But we actually have some breaking news, except it's not that breaking. It happened like 48 hours ago.
And it's such a coincidence, by the way.
Yeah. Literally, was it yesterday?
Yeah.
We were talking about Taylor Swift's Cruel Summer, and we were getting some Taylor Swift hate from the Kanye stans.
Yeah, it was me. It just, I will admit it. It was me.
Well, guess what? When I brought up Bananarama and how Bananarama's version of Cruel Summer was better, Bananarama also agrees. Because they just, well, I don't know how to explain it. How do you explain that? Basically, like, they're sad that they didn't copyright their song, and they're mad at Taylor Swift now. That's the gist.
And we were literally talking about it yesterday. Well, you were talking
about it. Yeah, I was literally talking about it yesterday.
It was their song.
I was like,
first.
Wait, guys, no, there's an original Cruel Summer, yeah. And it's by Bananarama.
Yeah, but
it's not originally by Taylor Swift.
Did you know that Taylor didn't copyright it? Or
I mean, like, I didn't, like, know, but I wouldn't guess that she would.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah, because honestly, I didn't know who Bananarama was until you
They're
said
from
it.
The 80s. So Cruel Summer is, like, an old song. It's from the 80s. But I don't know.
Yes, Taylor decided that she wanted it for herself, and then she took it, which is another
selfish,
reason why you should
Taylor.
Hate Taylor Swift. No, I'm joking.
Same name. Yeah,
okay.
The same name. That's a coincidence. There's also a TV show named Cruel Summer.
Okay, that's fair, but I still do not like Taylor Swift. And Bananarama should get their stuff back. Yes, I am reaching. Yes,
well,
I will.
Reaching, like,
I will.
Far.
It's okay.
Bananarama would like her to make it up to them.
Yeah.
She has nothing to make up to.
We're getting some Taylor Swift fan hating on us. Which is another reason you should
the
hate
Swifties,
Taylor Swift.
The Swifties are getting mad at us. The Swifties are getting mad at Bananarama.
Yeah, so now they want to want her to cover one of their songs.
Oh, yeah, yeah, yeah. So, as compensation for it, Bananarama wants Taylor Swift to cover their version of Cruel Summer, is it? Yeah. So, except that's never going to happen, and I wouldn't even listen to that anyway, so I don't know why Bananarama is suggesting
she
that.
Only plays songs about her ex-boyfriends anyway, so if they have a song like that, then maybe she'll consider it, but I guess not.
Yeah, well, anyways, guys, enough with the bantering. Let's listen to the superior Cruel Summer. This is Cruel Summer by Bananarama. And that was Cruel Summer by Bananarama. And to even prove to you that it's still superior to Taylor Swift's Cruel Summer, we all know, well, not we all, I don't want to speak for everybody, but a lot of people know Cruel Summer from Karate Kid. It's the iconic scene when he's on his bike and he like is he's at his first day of high school or whatever. Well, in the updated version of Karate Kid, which is basically Cobra Kai, it's like a Netflix original, they're not using Taylor Swift's version. They're still using the Bananarama version. As so that just shows that people are sticking to the roots, and it's superior.
And this is, like, my first time hearing the song, like, all the way, like, well, not all the way out, but, like, I like that. That was really good. It's good. I'm definitely adding that to one of my playlists after this. But you know what? We should talk about something else that's good, and that is Star Wars. And
we always come back to Star Wars.
Yes. We were talking about that probably, like, the first time we were on the show, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. And, you know, we were talking about, like, the Star Wars Snuggie. So if you do remember that, shout out to you, because we are going to have some information about that game later on. So, you know, make sure to tune in for that. But, oh, my gosh, there's been a lot of, like, Anakin edits on my For You page recently.
Which is so shocking. It's so shocking, because they've been on mine for, like, years.
Yeah, no.
I don't know if that just shows, like, a target audience.
I guess like, so. And this is exactly why I think TikTok is listening to everything, because, like, I didn't even look up anything at all, and I'm just over here getting, like, Star Wars TikToks and stuff, like, because I've been talking about it with you and, like, all my friends and everything like that, so.
You,
I don't know.
You
that's
watched
just crazy.
Revenge of the Sith. Once
my
and
life
now
changed.
Anakin is everywhere.
No, like, oh my god, that reminds me. Some girl on my Snapchat, she has a picture of Anakin in her car, and she she has it like with a heart on it, and it's I'm not gonna say what it says, but let's just say she definitely has a crush on Anakin, and I didn't go
after
that far.
This, you're gonna tell me who that is, because I'm so curious.
Yeah, I won't out the person, but.
Sorry, guys. Sorry to the listeners.
Yeah, but I don't know. I don't think I would ever have a picture of Anakin hanged up anywhere, but I would agree that he is a very good-looking character.
Mm-hmm.
That's all
I wouldn't
say.
Get, you know, a Anakin framed picture, but I would get a Darth Vader Snuggie, which you can too.
Yes, if you guys do check in at a later time, we will be giving out information, like I said, about that information, so just make sure to do that. And if you don't, then you're out of luck, I guess, which we're going to be playing Out of Touch by Hall and Oates.
last one.
Yeah. Hello, guys. We are back, and that was, what was that song again?
Out of Touch
by Hall & Oates. So, we were talking about Star Wars and everything like that. So, just so you guys know, next week on Monday, we will be having the trivia questions ready for you guys. So, just make sure to call in, and you can win a Star Wars Snuggie. And I know you Star Wars fans are so excited about that because, you know, since I'm a newly Star Wars fan, I would be excited about that, too. But mm-hmm. we were just given information that one of our AM students on Friday are going to be having a, like a discussion about the Star Wars movies and, like, like the track to it and just, like, their overall opinion on it. And we're not going to be there for that because we're PM. So we're just going to give you guys a little bit of insight on our opinion on the, like, the movie since we've been talking more about, like, pop culture, mm-hmm. like, whether or not the movie was actually good. So what do you think?
Well, one of her arguments was Hayden Christensen a good actor for Anakin?
Yeah.
And I remember watching some, like, documentary on YouTube. I fell down, like, a Star Wars rabbit hole at, like, 2 a.m. And it was George Lucas saying that he casted Hayden because he had, like, a good boyish look to him that was perfect for Anakin.
Yeah.
Which is true. Hayden looks like a really good Anakin, but his acting and the way he, like, portrays or just the way that he delivers dialogue is so painful.
Yeah,
like,
it was really
it's
corny
not good.
To watch. I'm not even gonna lie.
But he looks good.
I hate you, Mark. Oh my god. Yeah, we need to clip that in. But yeah, that was a little bit okay.
Shai, you had a confession?
Oh yes, guys, I do have a confession. So when I did watch the Star Wars movies, I watched an edited version of the movies. Actually,
you did.
Yes, because you guys probably already know my boyfriend Gabriel, because he's always on the Friday shows. He hates that one character that sounds like really squeaky, and I forgot the name of it, and I had it in my head earlier. It's like the I don't know its name. It's like a character. It was Padme's replacement when she was like hiding away. I forgot. Do you know who I'm talking about? It has, like, a squeaky voice.
Audience, do you know this?
Yeah, do you guys know who I'm talking about? It looks really weird. Yes, Jerry!
Jerry. Jar Jar Binks.
Sorry. Yes, Jar Jar. Yes, Jar Jar. Yes, there's an edited version of Star Wars where they got rid of all of Jar Jar's parts that are annoying.
Yes. Yeah.
Is he?
I
had no idea that there was Jar Jar Binks haters.
Yeah, I didn't either, but I guess it exists.
Really?
Yes.
Wow.
Everyone in the studio hates him, but yes, I did watch the edited version, so I didn't get to see him being annoying. So maybe
great.
I'll go watch that after this. thank you. But we're gonna wrap it up over here. I've been mm-hmm. Shiloh Curbelo.
I've been Olivia Esquivel.
And
oh.
Oh, and make sure to tune in for the trivia on Monday.
Oh, yeah.
Have a
we're
good
gonna
day,
be
guys. And we're going to be – you guys have to call in. Sorry, you guys have to call in. Make sure to call in on a Monday at 1 o'clock.
We'll be asking you guys some Star Wars trivia questions. So all you nerds out there, get ready. See you later.
Oh, yeah.
Thank you.
Thank you. Tomorrow during the break, and then we'll all three talk about it. Rich can tell me how we hooked it up last year,
yeah.
And then we'll put it on the calendar and make sure it's good.
Yeah, we got a meeting right next to the
okay.
Garage door number one. Fine, I'm yeah, you know, put this stuff on the way. But I can't. This is the radio station. Trips to move around. Use my live stream. So